Hello dear students, how are you? I hope you all are safe at home. So students, today I will teach you chapter 3 of Geo, Latitudes and Longitudes. Okay students, in this 3 points are there, geographical grid, latitudes and heat zones of the world and longitudes and time. So first point is introduction. Yes, students, as we know that our Earth is a unique planet, means like Earth, no planet is there. At the same time, it rotates on an imaginary line, passing through the center of the Earth and having ends at the poles. Poles, the last, upside and downside, this line is known as axis, right? The end of the axis are known as poles. Okay, the northern end, north means north, upside is north and downside is south. So upside pole is northern and downside southern pole, right? And also an imaginary circle equidistant from the two poles divided the earth into the two equal halves. Means earth is there, it is divided in two equal halves. This circle is known as the equator, means the middle line. In this picture you can see this is an equator, while the northern hemisphere and southern part is known as southern hemisphere, means northern upper side is north, northern hemisphere from equator, and downside south from equator to pole, southern hemisphere. Now about latitudes. What are latitudes? Dear students, the surface of the earth is very vast. On this vast surface, it is impossible to locate any place, right? Without using a mathematical method. Thus, we conceive imaginary lines. Imaginary, just think, okay? On the globe, you must have seen lines are there on that globe, black color, that is called. Imagine, that's it. Those are imaginary lines, not real. You know, one set of lines are called latitudes. And these imaginary lines, horizontal lines, parallel to each other. So, they are also known as parallels of latitudes or parallels. Right? They run east to west direction. And other latitudes are smaller circle. You can see in this picture, two yellow color parts are there, between line, that is equator on 0 degree, that is the biggest line, then another is smaller than smallest. Okay, like this. These are parallels but not same. Okay, all other latitudes are smaller circles parallel to it. Features of latitudes. Now, what are the features of latitudes? There are 180 parallels of latitude. How many? 180. 90 to the north and 90 to the south of the equator. How we can say, how we can understand this? Means this is equator. Upside 90, downside 90, total 180. Like this. Each parallel of latitude is a complete circle. This is a complete circle of the earth. Earth is like a ball and latitude is a complete circle. The parallel are equidistant except the poles. where the distance is a little more than it is near the equator. Right? Latitudes are of in unequal length. Length is not equal. You know, the equator is longest latitudes. You can see this. The longest line, then smaller, then smallest. So equator is the longest line and each circle becomes a ring. Ring, pole words. Means one ring, then another ring, then another ring. Like this. Our mayor points as 90 degree north. 90 degree north, 90 degree south. Right, now important latitudes. We can understand this from this picture. What are important latitudes? This one is, see, this one is equator. Equator is on 0 degree. Hai na? Upside, northern hemisphere from equator, and downside, southern hemisphere. Upside, this yellow area you can see from here. This is called Tropic of Cancer. Hai na? And this is on 23.5 degree north. Then green area, this is on 66.5 degree. This is Arctic Circle. And upside poles, this is on 90 degree. You know, this is North Pole. Same downside, this is Southern Hemisphere. And downside, this yellow part is Tropic of Cancer. And it is on 23.5 degree. So, then green area is there, you can see in your book clearly, 66.5 degree south. Then blue area, down it, towards southwards, it is on 90 degree and this is South Pole. Okay students, now about heat zones, What are heat zones? The amount of heat from where we are getting heat? From the sun. Right? From the sun we are getting heat. The amount of heat received from the sun by the earth's surface differs from place to place. In this topic we will understand why this is going on, why this is happening. Okay. The equator receives maximum amount of the heat and this heat gradually receives as we move towards the poles. So, one way of dividing the earth surface can be on the basis of amount of heat receives. Right. The earth is divided into zones. What are those zones called? Heat zones, heat zones. Same picture you can see, right? This is sun and this is earth. Zones are there. Yellow part, this is torrid zone. We are getting direct sunlight on it. You know? Torrid means, the word torrid means extremely hot. Okay, this zone lies between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Okay, this zone receives direct, you can see, sun is directly to the torrid zone. Okay, heat from the sun throughout the year. It is therefore the hottest zone on the earth. Next to it is this green area upside and downside, you can see, this is temperate zone. Temperate means mild or not extreme, not too cold, neither too hot. There are two temperate zones on the earth. Okay, northern temperate zone, southern temperate zone. Okay, these zones receive slanting, little bit slanting. Yeah, slanting. This line you can see, little bit slanting. Slanting heat from the sun. And these areas neither too hot nor too. The last one, blue area, you can see, this is frigid zone.
What is frigid?
The word fridge. Fridge, you know, too cold. Frigid means extremely cold. There are two frigid zones. Which one you can see? Northern frigid zone, southern frigid zone. These zones receive slanting rays from the sun. Means very few. And therefore, there is very little heat here, which makes the climate of this zone very much cold. Okay. Now, what are longitudes? What are longitudes? Unlike latitudes, longitudes are imaginary circles that runs in north-south direction. This picture you see, students, north-south direction, these are semicircles. Latitudes were full circle and these are semicircles. Okay, students. And pass through to the North Pole and South Pole. Unlike latitudes, longitudes are not equal spaced. But they are equal in length. Length is equal, but space is not equal. These lines are known as meridians. So what are the features of the longitudes? Unlike latitudes, longitudes are semicircle or equal length. These are semicircle. Already I told you, there are 3,316 longitudes. How many total lines are there? 360. 180 east side and 180 west side. Okay. 180 to the east of prime meridian and 180 to the west. Now, next is the coinciding longitudes will make a great circle. Like 30 degree east and 150 degree west will form a great circle. Okay, now next, the distance between two meridians does not remain constant. They are farthest apart at the equator and converge at the poles. Now, about international date line. What is international date line? How many lines are there? How many longitudes are there? 180 east side and 180 west side. Okay. So, 1/8, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, like this. 1/18th meridian. These are called meridian also. Meridian is called the international date line. And this line is drawn in a zigzag manner. In this picture, you can see this dark color, black color line. In zigzag manner, it is drawn and deviates at places on map so that it does not cut through any island or any country. You can see this is not cutting any land. And a traveler when crosses date line from east to west, he or she loses a day. While crosses the date line from west to east, she or he gains a day. Thus, if a person crosses the date line from east to west, say it is midnight, it will be the midnight of the previous day on the crossed side, or thus he or she experiences same calendar twice. Now, longitude and time. So, what is the connection between longitude and time? Dear students, as we know that the earth makes one complete rotation on its axis once in 24 hours. You all aware this? It means it rotates 360 degree in 24 hours. How many hours in a day? 24 hours. And earth is of 360 degree. How? 180 degree from this side, 180 degree from this side. Total 180 and 180, 360. This means it passes through 15 degree in 1 hour. Means when we will divide 360 to 15, to 24, we will get 15 degree. We will get the answer 15. So, in 1 hour, it will pass through 15 degree. Or in 1 degree in 4 minutes. Right? As the earth rotates west to east, it implies for every 15 degree we go eastwards. Local time is advanced by 1 hour conversely. Okay. For every 15 degree we go westward, local time is retarded by 1 hour. Right. Similarly, if we move 1 degree in east, we gain 4 minutes. And on moving 1 degree in the west, we lose 4 minutes. Now about standard time and time zone. Okay. So how many time zones are there in the world? 24 time zones are there. In the world has been divided into 24 time zones. And on page number 130, first paragraph, last line, you can read. Okay. We know that every country has its own local time. Vis-a-vis GMT. GMT is Greenwich time. Okay. Imagine if each city and town kept time as per each longitude. Hana? This passes through it. Which passes through from there? What will happen? There would be so much difference. There would be so much differences in time between one city and another. In a big country like India, there would be too many different times. And what will happen? This will lead to confusion and cross regarding train timing, serial timing, TV timing, and our daily routine activities, it will affect. Time will not seem if each city has their own time, how smoothness will come. You know? This means having time for every longitude is impractical and inconvenient. To avoid this mess, we adopt a system of standard time. This means every country accepts a time associated with meridian. Right? Like longitudes passing through it as its standard time. The standard time is accepted as same all over the country. In India, the meridian is 82 degree 30 east has been accepted for Indian standard time. Thus, 15 is 5 hours, 30 minutes, you know, 50 ahead of Greenwich mean time. However, large countries like USA, Russia, Canada, etc. have their vast, vast expanse. So many land they have. These countries are divided in more than one zone for practical purpose. They have their own standard time, and there are 24 time zones in the world. Like Russia has 1120 zones. Okay. And USA has 5 time zones, right? So dear students, I hope you have understand the lesson. Okay, first you will read the lesson, you will watch the video, then you will do exercises. Okay, read the lesson two times and you are not watching videos, why? If you will not watch, how you will understand? You will, when you will listen carefully only, then you can understand. Stay home, stay safe, bye.